Praise God, brothers and sisters. I've made a video. I'm making a second video now because I want to finish it up, what I was talking about. Bad things are coming. They've already been coming. It's going to get worse in this world. But Jesus has overcome the world. That's what he wants me to tell you. You know, it's like that song, that old hymnal. And I'm going to put an anointed version link down here below this video. But anointed, believe it or not, a Mennonite. The Amish are a branch of the Mennonites. Mennonites are like one larger group. I got a singing link down here from a group of Mennonites. Church of God Mennonite people, Pentecostal Mennonites, singing Leaning on the Everlasting Arms. I ask you to please listen to it and get that down in your spirit. Because when all the things are going on in the world, we got to lean on Jesus. Hallelujah. And people keep looking to the world. So why you keep looking at the world? We need to be looking at Jesus. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Keep your eyes on Jesus and keep your eyes off the world. It's like Peter when he started walking on the water. He was looking at Jesus and he was walking on the water. As soon as he looked at the storm, he sank. It's just so simple. It's just so simple. Keep your eyes on Jesus. Keep your eyes on the Lord. Don't look at all these things. Because we don't need to be involved in that. Look, it's just like the WWF. It's just like Worldwide Wrestling. It's all fake. It's all the Matrix. It's all a facade, brothers and sisters. I'm telling you. It has no eternal consequences. You know, you can read in the history book. I love history. And I used to, you know, and I love politics and all that. But in the end, brothers and sisters, it don't matter. The only thing that matters is, do you know Jesus? That's the only thing. Jesus will say one of two things to you when you see him. Enter into your rest, my good and faithful servant. Or depart from me, I never knew you. So that's the ultimate question of the ages, brothers and sisters. Not, you know, who's the biggest loser, Obama or McCain or which of them, you know, the biggest loser contest, who they can, you know, the Illuminati and the powers that be, the man, they sit back and say, you know, let's knock down these twin towers. Let the Muslims knock down twin towers there in New York on 9/11, and then let's elect a guy. Let's force the American people, you know, manipulate the American people to elect a guy with a Muslim name who went to a Muslim school, a madrasa in Indonesia, and it's questionable where he was from, where he was born, what religion he is, what race is he, where's he from. Everything's all questioned. Let's throw this guy in there and show them that we can turn around after having, you know, a war against. It's really a holy war against this religion of Islam. That's exactly what it is. It's a war between Islam and the Judeo-Christian civilization. And let's put a guy in there with a name, Barack Hussein Obama, just to show the people that we're in charge of this planet, brothers and sisters. Even as the Bible tells us, Satan is the god of this world, the prince and power of the air. Until Jesus comes back, the physical, natural world that we live in, the dominion, Adam surrendered to Satan. When Jesus came and got the keys to the kingdom, we have a spiritual kingdom. Jesus said the kingdom is within you. Our hearts, our spirit has been redeemed, but we're still in this world. You know, that's basic biblical doctrine. Why? Did you ever get sick? A result of the fallen world. Do you ever see anybody that died? Because we're living in a fallen world. Brothers and sisters, the effect of the fall and sin that Satan is the god of this world, all you got to do is turn on the television, watch 30 seconds of the news, listen to lying, perverted politicians, lying, perverted priests, false doctrines, sickness and disease, Ebola, wars and rumors of wars. Satan is doing his best in this world, brothers and sisters, to divide and conquer this world, brothers and sisters. That's why there's only unity in Christ. There's only unity and safety in Christ. The Bible says, Amos 3:3, how can two walk together except they be in agreement? Now, brothers and sisters, if I'm walking with Jesus and you're walking with Jesus, well, then we should be walking together now, shouldn't we? If we're not walking together, then one of us or both of us is not walking with Jesus. Hallelujah. You got to walk with Jesus, and I'll walk with Jesus, and then we'll be walking together. How good and pleasant it is when brethren dwell together in unity. It's even as the oil that ran down from Aaron's beard, even to the bottom of his garment, brothers and sisters. So fear not, brothers and sisters, those things that's coming upon the world. Faint not at tribulation that's coming on this world, brothers and sisters. For if God be for you, who can be against you? What does that song say? What have I to dread? What have I to fear? Leaning on the everlasting arms. Hallelujah. Leaning, safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning, Leaning on the everlasting arms, what have I to dread? What have I to fear? Leaning on the everlasting arms. Hallelujah. You got to lean on Jesus. Lean on the everlasting arms. What do you got to fear? What do you got to dread when you're with Jesus? Brothers and sisters, put your faith, your hope, and your trust in Jesus Christ, because the things of this world are perishing. They're falling away. The Republicans will pass away. Democrats will pass away. All of these politicians that people want to make into a god and a hero like President Bush, they thought he was a savior. And the liberals, they think Obama is a savior. They thought he was. They've already found out he wasn't. Bush was not a savior. Hallelujah. All these politicians are liars and thieves. Sold their soul to have power in this temporal world, in this world that's fading away and perishing. Hallelujah. As for me and my house, we have decided to follow Jesus. Hallelujah. Follow Jesus. Sing the song. You sing with me, brother. I keep saying, I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. Don't turn back now, hallelujah, because what's behind you is nothing but destruction and evil, brothers and sisters. Don't be like Lot's wife and turn back and look at this world. Hallelujah, there's nothing in this world. This world has nothing for me. I will follow you. That's another song. This world has nothing for me. I will follow you. Hallelujah. Let's follow Jesus, brothers and sisters. Let's turn our eyes upon Jesus. Hallelujah. And the things of this world will grow strangely dim. You know, brothers and sisters, the Lord has put this into my heart. In the last video I made, I quoted the Psalm 91. You know, those things are growing worse and worse and waxing worse. Destruction, wars, rumors of war, earthquakes in diverse places, all that stuff, brothers and sisters. You know, like Matthew 24:7 is just what I was just quoting from. Brothers and sisters, those things are coming on the earth leading up. It's birth pains. Jesus said the tribulation and his return is like a woman in labor, a woman in travail, it says in the King James. You know, so it's a process. God is restoring the earth back to Jesus' kingdom. What are we supposed to pray? Father, let thy will be done. Let thy kingdom come. Let thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So the kingdom of the Lord is being restored. And the process is known as the tribulation period. But leading up to that, the earth is in labor, as Paul said, even till now. The whole creation is groaning and in travail, in labor, that the sons of God would be revealed. What is that? He's talking about the rapture, talking about the resurrection of the true bride, the saints of God, hallelujah, the true church, hallelujah, the sons of God to be revealed, hallelujah. John chapter 1, to many as believe on his name, to them he gave power who believe on Jesus to become children of God, hallelujah. And we will be revealed. Those who are true Christians, I mentioned in the last video, but I split it because I'm tired of making the long, long videos. I split the video. We will be revealed at the rapture. God's church universal. God's church invisible, brothers and sisters. It's not a denomination name. Hallelujah, Baptist, Catholic, whatever. In every place in the world, people that don't go to church, there are people who are born again. You don't know it. That's why we're not supposed to judge. You don't know who is a Christian, who's not. They know. God knows, because how do we know that you're a Christian? Romans 8:16. His spirit bears witness with our spirit that we are sons of God. Hallelujah. I know I'm a Christian because the Lord's spirit has bear witness with me. I know in my spirit that I'm a child of God. God confirms it to me. And if I have any doubts, I'll go to the Lord again and keep, you know, talking to the Lord and speaking to him until I get assurance and have that blessed assurance in my spirit. Hallelujah. You know, like they say, get in the ring and wrestle until you know that you know that you know. Hallelujah, that you're born again. If you don't know that you know that you know, you got to keep wrestling with God until you know. You got to get in there. Hallelujah. You know, this is your eternal destiny. This is your relationship with God. It's not my relationship with God. That's the problem. The real problem and the basis of all the trouble with the Catholic Church and people. Tons of people I talk to, they're looking for another mediator. The Bible says there is one mediator between God and man. That's Jesus Christ. You know, I can't mediate for you. I can pray for you. You got to mediate. You got to get in there with the mediator. You got to talk to Jesus, hallelujah, to be saved. All these people, I can't, get you saved. I can give you what the Bible tells you to do. You got to get yourself saved with God. You got to talk to the Lord, hallelujah. You got to have a little talk with Jesus to make it right. Hallelujah. When you feel a little prayer wheel turning, know a little fire is burning, and you'll find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. That's another song. Oh, let's have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about our troubles. He will hear our faintest cry. He will answer by and by. So when you feel a little prayer wheel turning, know a little fire is burning. You'll find a little talk with Jesus makes it right. Brothers and sisters, you got to get in the ring. You got to get in there and wrestle around. Just like Jacob did. Jacob wrestled with the angel of the Lord until he changed his name to Israel. Hallelujah. He changed his name from supplanter or heel grabber or trying to take somebody else's place to Israel. He who wrestles with God and man and overcomes. Hallelujah. Get in there and let the Lord change your name to Christian, to being a follower of Jesus, a born again child of God, a member of the church invisible, church universal. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. You got to be a member of the church, not a church, but the church. Hallelujah. Now, the local manifestation of the church is what people are talking about. You go to a local assembly of born-again believers, that's a local manifestation of the body of Christ. Hallelujah. Lots of you, the church you go to is the armpit, It's not the right hand or the voice of God, but the armpit of God, Lots of people are stuck in those churches. There seems to be the vast majority of the churches are in that category, brothers and sisters. But that's why the Bible tells us to come out from among them. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. Anyway, I just wanted to get on here and make this second video to continue the message that the Lord gave me. And it's basically, when the Lord is speaking to us, brothers and sisters, as Christians, He exhorts us and encourages us usually. Now, there's times when He tells us to repent and all that kind of stuff. But when destruction is coming, as I mentioned in the last video, when God gives the word that destruction is coming, when you're talking to non-believers, like Jonah did in Nineveh, you say, hey, repent, destruction's coming, you all those guys going to go to hell, all this kind of stuff. If you don't repent, get right with God. That's for the world, brothers and sisters, but for us who are part of the bride, the Lord doesn't, it's not about destructions, it's about comforting my people. It's about, drawing close to God, getting in the secret place of the Most High. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High abides under the shadow of the Almighty. I hope that you guys can understand those King James words, because it says he who dwells, to dwell is to live. He who lives in the secret place of the Most High, he who stays in prayer all the time, shall abide, remain under the shadow of the Almighty. If you spend all your time with Jesus, let me put it in modern day language. If you spend all your time with Jesus, he's going to protect you from the destruction. That's what it says. The Lord is my refuge and my strength, my shield, my buckler, and my God, and him I shall trust. Hallelujah. God will deliver me. Why? Because I set my love upon him. Because I remain in the secret place. I stay in the presence of God. I'm always leaning forward into the presence of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I got the wind of the Holy Spirit at my back, pushing me into the kingdom. That's a whole other message that, I just got a little nugget drop again. Hallelujah. From God. Hallelujah. Many of you guys love to keep walking, into the wind. Hallelujah. You're supposed to have the wind at your back pushing you into the kingdom of God. But instead, a lot of you are crying, walk against the wind, brothers and sisters. Some of you get sideways, God says go do this, but you say, oh, I'm going to go do this. Some of you say, I'm going to do the opposite. I'm going to do what the devil wants me to do. You're walking into a headwind. A few of you are walking with the wind to your back, walking right into the will of God, but lots of people are going sideways, cross-cutting the wind, trying to get some kind of a different angle on, God wanted me to go here, but now I want to go over here. God told me to mow the grass at the local assembly church, but I've decided, oh, I'm the next Elijah. I've decided that I am the last priestly prophet. I am the Messiah. I am Moses. I'm one of the two witnesses. I am one of the 144,000. How many people who are saying these things, brothers and sisters? It's a sign of the end times, but that strong delusion is coming on multitudes, brothers and sisters. And except we dwell in the secret place of the Most High, it's the same thing can happen to any of us. Except for the grace of God, these things can happen to us, brothers and sisters. That's what the Bible says. When you think you can't fall, you can fall. That's the pride when you say, oh, I can't fall. It's what the Word of God tells us. You know, when you when you think you stand, is what, you know, that's when you can fall, brothers and sisters. We must be rooted and grounded in the Word. We must continually humble ourselves. That's what I talked about in the last video too. We must continually humble ourselves unto God. Don't have a haughty spirit. Pride goes before destruction, a haughty spirit before a fall. Don't be a pompous jerk. Are you going to fall? Let's put it in modern terms. Don't be a pompous, know-it-all, pharisaical jerk, self-righteous jerk, because you're going to fall. That's what the Word of God is trying to tell us. Humble yourself. God gives grace to the humble, but He resists the proud, brothers and sisters. Now things are going to get worse and worse, and all hell is breaking loose, literally, and it's only going to grow worse and worse and worse. All kinds of judgments and things are falling and going to fall as we approach the tribulation. He who dwell in the secret place of the Most High God, remain under the shadow of the Almighty. Hallelujah. Get into Christ and stay there. Get into the kingdom. Get into the body of Christ. Get into the heart of Christ and stay there. Grab a hold of the horns of the altar, as it says in the Old Testament. Hallelujah. Well, the judgment can't come on you when you grab a hold of the horns of the altar. It's a whole other message I could give. I need to make notes myself. There's a sister from Georgia who told me she would make notes of my little nuggets and email it to me. Now, I know you said you were. And I'm waiting for you to do it, sister, because I know that I need to go back and make a sermon on all those things I said. Praise God, because I know that there's some great wisdom in there that the Lord would let me dig out of that little vein of gold. You know, I'd have to go in there and dig it out. You know, but me, I can't go in all those directions in one video, even though I try. Praise God, brothers and sisters. You know that I love you. I know that I love you. Be aware, brothers and sisters. Don't get into the ditch of legalism. Don't get into the ditch of greasy graceism. You know, don't get into these ditches of anyone that doesn't believe in the rapture is going to hell. And don't get into the ditch that, you have to do some special tricks and all this to go to heaven above and beyond the gospel, brothers and sisters. You know, just keep your eyes on Jesus. Humble yourself. Keep seeking Him. God gives grace to the humble. It's not a matter of fact that we're perfect. We'll never be perfect, brothers and sisters. You'll never be perfect in this world. But you know that you're not perfect. You know you need grace, and you humbly seek God every day. Humbly seek His grace, His mercy, His forgiveness. And knowing that we have no license to sin, and seek God. Hallelujah. Praise God, brothers and sisters. The Lord, wants His people to be at peace. God is not the author of confusion, but the author of peace. God wants us to have peace, brothers and sisters. All this running to and fro and all this, wild breaking news and speculation every day. I don't see how people haven't had strokes and heart attacks now. And lots of people have fallen away already. Of course, they won't be watching this video. They fell away. Tons of people already fallen away because they thought the rapture was coming with Comet Elanon in 2011 and all this other stuff. And 2012 and all that stuff, brothers and sisters. You know, don't be a one-hit wonder. You know, stay the course. And you know, one time I made a video a year or two ago when I said, we're not in a sprint, but, it's a marathon. And of course, I had two or three of the, date setters tell me, oh, we're in a sprint. No, the church has been in a marathon for 2,000 years. Hallelujah. And we are going to go ahead and run on to the finish line. If it's 1 week or 1 year or 5 years or 10 years or what? We stay the course in Christ, brothers and sisters. Be steadfast and unmovable in Christ. Let your heart not be troubled. Believe in God. Even also in the Lord Jesus Christ. He's coming to get us. He's preparing a place for us, and He's coming for us in the day that the Heavenly Father deems. The Lord will not be bound by a Feast of Trumpets or any other dates that people try to set. The Lord will come whenever He wants to, at a time when you least expect, He said. He'll come as a thief in the night for His bride. Take us back to heaven to be with Him. Unlike the second coming, when every eye will see Him, He'll return to earth and all that, and rule and reign with the rod of iron. That's the end of the tribulation, but He's coming before the tribulation for His bride. Love you guys. God bless. May the peace of the Lord be with you. May the Lord let His peace rest upon you. May He lift up His countenance on you. Give you peace in the name of Jesus Christ. I just speak it right now. Father, I ask you, Lord, just to release your peace upon all those who watch this video right now. I speak right now that the Lord's holy angels be with each one of you right now in the name of Jesus. To lift you up out of the miry clay, to lift you out of the pit of depression. Hallelujah. I speak it right now that the holy angels of God be with you to lift you take you above so that you might see the things of God. See things as God sees things, not as the way the world sees things. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless you. Hallelujah. With strength in your inner man. Hallelujah. That you be able to run the race with patience. Hallelujah. That the Lord has set before each one of us. Hallelujah. As we each have an individual race, and we as a church have a race together. Hallelujah. Working in unity as the Lord would orchestrate and coordinate all the things that He would have done. Not by might nor by power, but by my Spirit, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise be God through whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all ye creatures here below. Praise God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. I love you. I love all you guys, and you know that. And I praise the Lord for each person that, you know, comments and messages with me, the brothers and sisters I fellowship and talk with, the sister that gave me the pumpkin pie and cheese and strawberry cheesecake. You know, my taste buds thank you, but maybe my stomach doesn't thank you. Woo! Well, brothers and sisters, praise God, praise God, praise God. And the oil has been, you know, has been a huge blessing from the Lord to those who've received it. Praise God for that. It's been an overwhelming response to the prayer oil. I've still, you know, I got a new batch. I've been praying over it, and I think I'm caught up right now. Praise God for that, the prayer oil in the book that the Lord gave me to write for the orphanages, the support of the orphanages. Praise God for that, brothers and sisters. God bless.